In my last video about this EPEver SHI400 pure sine wave inverter, we had a few issues. We found that my oscilloscope went a bit crazy when it was switched on, and we could also hear some audio interference on the microphone. And therefore, in this video, I want to look at ways of reducing RFI radio frequency interference, which I think is what we were seeing, and how we can reduce it so that we don't have that effect anymore, no annoying audio on the videos, and we'll be able to look at it more closely on the scope. So in this video, I'm going to have a quick look at four different ways of reducing RFI and see if we can eradicate it completely. Now, the first method is by far the simplest, and it's shielding the oscilloscope and my microphone cable from the EPEver inverter. So this is in an aluminium case, but unfortunately the ends are plastic, and therefore potentially RFI is escaping quite easily. Now, I don't have a metal box quite big enough to put this EPEver inverter in, but I do have two halves of metal boxes which roughly fit together, and this may well improve things. Even though this has got some reasonably large holes in it, hopefully we may see a reduction. Now, with the oscilloscope fired up, let's turn on the EPEver inverter. I think we're getting the audio noise, and we can see that the oscilloscope is going a bit crazy. Let's cover this up. And I'm not sure that's any better whatsoever. Now, the next method I want to look at is cancellation. Now, that's a method used in a lot of data carrying cables, where you actually twist the cables around each other, and that cancels the interference. So I think I'm going to try that both on the input cables and the output cables. So you can see my main input wires here are twisted together now. There's probably about 6 or 7 twists in there in total. That's because, well, this is quite a short piece of cable, because that's what you're meant to do on an inverter. So hopefully this will have a more positive effect than the shielding. I think we're ready for the cancellation test now, so let's turn on the inverter. There, the oscilloscope is still showing some oddities, yes, and I think on the VU meter on my screen, I can see there is still some background noise. So, unfortunately, cancellation doesn't seem to be working. I've placed this capacitor on the input to the EPEver now to try theory number 3, which is filtering. And I'm just throwing a capacitor on there. It's a 16 volt, 1000 microfarad capacitor, hoping that that might filter out some of this RFI noise. So let's give it a go. Well, straight away I can see the VU meter on the camera here is showing some background noise, but actually my oscilloscope seems to be behaving a lot better. So that's certainly a positive. So the fourth and final little experiment to try and reduce the RFI on this EPEver pure sine wave inverter is to use some of these, some ferrite rings, and they're going to sit on the input cable. In fact, I might try and twist the cable through twice. I think it will just go, and these should reduce any interference, any radio interference on these cables. I guess we'll wait and see. So there we have the ferrite rings on the input cables. It was pretty tight getting those two rounds of cables through those rings, but I just about managed it. So with those ferrite rings on the input, do we see and indeed hear any difference? Again, the oscilloscope does seem to be behaving better, but I think the audio is just the same. So after all those tests, I found that the capacitor and the ferrite ring seemed to show the best improvement. It wasn't the full improvement that I was after, because there was still that noise on the audio. However, it was making my oscilloscope behave normally. However, I did continue to try a few other things, and I found out what was picking up the interference on an audio level. As soon as I remove this audio extension cable from my microphone, the noise has gone away entirely. Don't believe me? Well, this whole shot, the inverter's been switched on, creating power, and working fine. So I've got to the bottom of that problem, and not all of it is the fault of the EPEver, I would suggest. So hopefully you've enjoyed this video. If you have, give me a thumbs up, subscribe down below, comment if you can, and I'll see you next time. And sorry for all that horrible noise all the way through this video.